You have learnt what is qualitative research. If not, please go through qualitative research module and try to understand it. There are various methods which fall under qualitative analysis type. In qualitative analysis, we study people, culture, phenomenon, interventions in detail and we analyze it qualitatively. Now we are focusing on such an analysis of a culture. Say, if we come across a tribal locality, culture, on an isolated island and we want to study that culture, then what kind of analysis we will do? This study will fall under ethnographic research. Let us understand what is an ethnographic research. Ethnography. The word ethnography is made of two words, ethnos and graphia. What is ethnos? Ethnos means a culture, people, a race. Graphia means writing or representing. So writing or representing about people, about a race, about a culture is ethnography. So ethnography is the discovery and comprehensive description of the culture of a group of people. What is a culture? Let us understand. A culture is a system of shared beliefs, values, practices, perspectives, folk knowledge, language, norms, rituals, and material objects and artifacts that members of a group use in understanding their world and relating to others. So, whenever we study a particular system which has its own beliefs, own language, own practices, material, objects, then we say we are studying a culture. What are all aspects of a culture? Let us understand. Culture has shared beliefs. These are some norms, some statements which people of that particular community hold as true. Means they all believe in some norms. So those are shared beliefs. Those beliefs are shared by the whole culture. There are some shared values also. People of the entire system, culture, believe that certain things are good, certain things are bad. So those are standards for that particular culture. Those are some desirable things, acceptable things, or maybe they are undesirable things. A culture also has some norms. Norms are some written or unwritten rules which are trusted to be followed by entire community. So those are norms of that culture. Culture can be viewed as varying on a continuum. Culture can be a macro culture and a micro culture. When we say we are planning to study all beliefs, standards, norms, language, values of the entire country, it's macro culture. Can you imagine that a small classroom also has its own culture? All students of that classroom share some common values, beliefs. They may have their code language also. If we study one small classroom, their language, their style, their thinking, then it will be study of a micro culture. And in between, right from country to classroom, there is a continuum. There are two types of ethnographic research. One is ethnology and other is ethnohistory. What is ethnology? Ethnology is comparative study of two different cultures. Briefly, comparative study of these cultural groups involves conducting and comparing a series of separate ethnographic studies of the same or different cultures. Similarities and differences among the people are looked for. For example, if we find two islands very close by, many things about peoples living on this island and this island are same. But still, because they are isolated from each other, there may be some differences. Some rituals, some commonalities in language may be found. But to analyze and study exactly what similarities are observed and what differences are observed, we may conduct ethnographic study. This kind of ethnographic research will be ethnology. So ethnohistory is study of cultural past of a group of people. This is often done during the early stages of an ethnography, and ethnohistory aims at uncovering the group members' cultural roots and to study how the group has changed or not changed over time. If we are focusing only on one group, we want to study that culture, but initially we would like to know from where they have evolved. So if we enter into the history past of that particular culture, if we try to find out roots of that culture, then we are talking about ethnohistory. Let us see some features of ethnographic research related to its data collection strategies and analysis strategies. If you have to study a culture, would you be able to just conduct a survey and study it? Certainly not. Researcher will need to spend a long time in that culture. It will involve detailed study and a field work. This researcher will need to be an active participant or otherwise non-participant observer, but living in that culture for a while. Becoming a participant as far as possible will be an important aspect of this research. Let us see another feature of ethnographic research. Data collection and data analysis in ethnographic research are concurrent or sometimes alternative. For example, we may start doing a particular study. So we start with data collection and then we realize that there needs to be change in our approach. Some new things have emerged. So in data collection, we start changing the plan. After data collection or along with data collection, if we start data analysis, we have another advantage. During analysis, we understand that we want some more data on one of the other aspects which was otherwise neglected. So in analysis, we also start data collection. This will not happen in very tight quantitative research because everything is rigid, systematic, step by step. But ethnographic research, because it is a qualitative research, gives us this possibility. Data analysis can be started along with data collection, and data collection can happen again during the stages of data analysis. Emergent, fluid and responsive approach is main feature here, because sometimes original research changes. In characteristics of qualitative research, we have seen that qualitative research has emergent design. The design itself may emerge during the phases of study. Design changes. It becomes fluid. It becomes responsive. So, as we go on studying a particular culture, several research related aspects of our design may change, may give us some different feedback, and it may change our approach. One important feature of ethnographic research is people, about people. Studying what people think, talking to them, understanding them is very important. When we talk to people, interview them, try to understand their views and perspectives, we go into depth of ethnographic research. Along with talking to people, going through their documents, going through their notes, material created by this group of people is also important. So, when a researcher does ethnographic study, he or she observes people, keep notes, write memos, record their observations on daily basis, keep regular notes based on these observations. Not only observations, but thoughts and interpretations on his or her own observation is also significant in this study. When we say that a researcher needs to become a participant or a non-participant observer of a particular culture, he or she needs to take a precaution. When we study, observe, analyze different culture, there may be chances that we are viewing that culture, observing that culture from our own perspective. If we try to compare every norm, every ritual, every belief, value of that culture from my cultural point of view, then there may be a problem. So even though we are participant, even though my beliefs, my perspective is important, I should not be comparing my culture with that culture. Then only ethnographic study will be effective. There are two approaches of ethnographic research: emic perspective and ethic perspective. Let us see what is emic perspective. In emic perspective, we consider insider's perspective. What is that? It includes meanings and views of the people in the group being studied. Critical to the ethnographer's primary goal of learning the world of his or own host, critical to the ethnographer's primary goal of learning the world of his or her host community from the perspectives of its members. In emic perspective, researcher tries to understand what people of that community, the culture who are hosting this researcher, think. What are their beliefs? What are their perspectives, thoughts about their own culture? So interviewing people, talking to them, finding out their perspective behind all the rituals are important by emic perspective. This is insider's perspective. Spatial terms or words used by the people in the group also matter. Terms given by researcher for that particular culture also matters. The terms which are given by people of that culture for everything are known as emic terms, because that is related to emic perspective of that culture. Let's take a small example. A group of new literates about IT who are first time approaching IT computer may coin their own words. For example, students who are first time viewing computer may start calling pointer, mouse pointer as a needle. They may not know the word sand clock and they may start labeling that word differently. Now all these terminologies which that group has evolved are known as emic terms. Now if that researcher's own perspective about hosting community, about hosting culture is important, it is called as ethic perspective. You will realize that studying a culture from both angles, collecting data, understanding people's view about it, whose culture it is, and researcher's view about that culture as a non-participant observer or a neutral observer is important. An external social scientific view of reality is known as ethic perspective. The perspective of the objective researcher studying a group of people is this perspective. Here, understanding the perspectives of ethnographic host through rigorous and iterative observations, interviewing, and other modes of ethnographic inquiry are important. So, observations, interviewing and then interpreting, ethnographic inquiry will give us ethic perspective. Terms coined by researchers for describing, studying, analyzing and interpreting a particular culture are ethic terms. These are outsiders terms, social scientists terms, social science concepts, terms and procedures used by the researchers to describe people and their behavior are therefore known as ethic terms.